Oh, definitely. It was our way of saying farewell. We wanted everybody to be aware of that because, you know, we'd often been asked, are you ever going to do another tour? And we wanted people to really understand that we can't keep doing it. Obviously, we weren't going to live forever. There had to be a time where we'd be saying goodbye to people.
Well, performing the carnival is over is always an emotional event for all of us, and for me particularly, because it happens to be my favourite Seekers song.
You just simply couldn't have a better finishing, you know, song to your repertoire. Yes, it is very poignant, and it is a farewell song. It's a summary song emotionally as well. You know, it collects everything, right? Doesn't matter what you've done right through the whole show, that gathers everybody up.
The fantastic thing for the Seekers is that our music is timeless.
Longevity, I think it has a lot to do with the power of the music. People use the term timeless. They're memorable, they've lasted through generations, and that's reflected in the people that were coming along to those concerts, particularly the 50th anniversary, the Golden Jubilee.
Well, still being together 50 years later, there was no way we would have thought that, because in fact in 1968, when we thought our career was on the wane, because our record sales had started to decline, etc., we thought it was about time that we looked for other employment.
So the Seekers emerged at a really interesting time in music. Alongside the Beatles, the predominant genre of the time was wholesome folk pop. Alongside this, Elvis was dominating the chart in the US and the Shadows in the UK. What the Seekers produced was a distillation of all that was going on, but with a slight Australian inflection that was safe and palatable for the global masses. And it's an important point to make, these were much less global times, so for an Australian artist to have global success was really quite unprecedented.
I think the standard of songwriting when we were in England was just astounding. I mean, every day a new record came out by someone or other, and I was just continually blown away about how great the songs were. And those songs have also stood the test of time.
And there's just something about the sound as well, the musicality of the voices together, you know, with Judith's really strong lead, the harmonics. We were just lucky that, you know, we found that pigeonhole that we owned and never departed from, really, and the longevity of the music, you know, sort of gave us that platform to come back to.
The most thrilling part of it was that we were creeping up to a 50-year birthday party.
It was in 2011 that André Rieu had the great idea of bringing back the Seekers. He was by then a very established artist in Australia and toured almost every year, and for his 2011 tour, chose to engage the Seekers. So it was a re-engagement of the four of them, and they came together at the end of the show and sang four or five songs and brought the house down.
2011, we toured with André, and it was a magic experience. It was fantastic. And one of the things that along the way it proved to me, the versatility of Seekers' songs. Now, we only sang four songs in the show, but boy, were they the most uplifting songs that you could have an orchestra underneath.
When Judith and Bruce and Athol and I reunited in 1993 to mark our 25-year anniversary, it seemed like that was about as far as we would go. But then we realised that we still had a lot of energy, and we still had a lot of life, we still enjoyed being on stage, we enjoyed each other's company. So I guess the years just rolled on very quickly, and suddenly we found ourselves 50 years down the trail, and there we were.
A lovely sense of anticipation. It's helped by the fact that you've sold all the tickets. There's nothing more reassuring than knowing that everybody in the hall was ready to give you that great welcome.
It was a very special and exciting time to be planning to literally go on stage, especially because the audience was so excited about this happening. I mean, all of us were so aware that it was a once-only opportunity.
I've kept saying all my life with the Seekers, it doesn't get any better than this. And at this time, I mean it. It just does not get any better than this 50th reunion. And what I've seen and what I've heard, Michael's done a Michael Cristiano, our little genius producer and musical director, he's pulled together a beautiful, beautiful show. And I've seen other great shows from other artists. For our fans, I reckon they're going to, I think they'll treasure it.
What I think what people will find surprising about Farewell is just how great the performance is. They were fantastic. They were just so good. Everyone. Judith was just singing as well as she ever has. And the three boys were playing and singing as well as they ever had. It's quite a few magical moments that I think probably better than a lot of the other recordings they've done. But this one in particular, they just look like they're having a ball. And I think that's going to come across to the fans.
I'm really thrilled and proud of the job that Michael Cristiano, our producer, has done in remixing the songs from those shows. The end result is just superb. It's the most faithful reproduction of the Seekers sound I think I've ever heard.
I think the Golden Jubilee Farewell Tour is the jewel in the crown as far as the Seekers fans are concerned. It's the product that they've been waiting to be released for probably 6 years now, so it's been a long time coming and we are absolutely delighted to be able to share this with the fans now.
Seekers fans, I would say, can expect from the Farewell CD and DVD probably the pinnacle of our live performance recording. There's quality, Judith's voice, unmistakable, fantastic, one of the great singers of 21st century. And we performed to our very best. We had great fun. And I believe that all of that comes across on this recording. And it's a massive achievement, I think.
I mean, I didn't dream that our music would still live on. It never crossed my mind. I thought, oh, right, I'll leave the group. Everybody's going to move on, fashions will change. It never occurred to me that 25 years later we'd still be around, let alone 50 years later, you know, that people would still love those beautiful, timeless melodies.